Now, in the words of my grandmother, who is resting in eternity, to sleep is always a chance to die, so stay awake. And if in your tent sleeping, wake up to another Sunday morning, day number 3. The 20th annual Sierra Nevada World Music Festival. If I don't get a chance to talk to you before you all leave, a safe sojourn to your destination. I know many of you came from far, and if some of you from near, we want to thank you all for coming out, for showing love and being on your best behavior, especially those who brought their babies here. We want to thank them for having trust and confidence in the festival that everything is going to be all right. And especially you once more for being on your absolutely, positively best behavior. Now, many of you have been waiting like a lamb to the slaughter, like a dog in a manger, waiting to see the two brothers we're going to bring on stage. They've been in the recording business since the Rocksteady era. They're in the house. They're going to sing for you, walk and don't look back. If your first lover leave you, walk and don't look back. Oh my goodness. Are you ready for Pete and Dix? This is the Virgin Appearance inside the Sierra Nevada World Music Festival. Their first appearance. Give them a warm round of applause. Let them hear your voices. Don't let them sing and stay by themselves. Pete and Dix.
Yeah, we're about all about Rocksteady, all right? Dear Rocksteady today. Big up yourselves. Do us one favor. Give yourselves a hand. Come on. Arriba. So, don't want to come on up here and sing, you know what I mean? Because in Rocksteady, take it on, guys. In Rocksteady, there's a story to be told. So we started, I was 16 and he was,
oh, what were you? 17.
He's older than me, actually.
I'm still 17.
But, so we started a long time ago, and there are some influences that we've had. And so we're going to play a few songs, a medley of songs that illustrates and tells you what we heard then and what influenced us. All right?
All right.
Influencers, Clarin Donors, two guys, you know, Ernest and Peter, and you had the Blues Busters. I tell you what, the Blues Busters, man, they, from a little kid, you know, you're looking up and you say, oh, geez, these guys are good, and you want to be like them, you know? Many influences. We're going to now do some of our songs. How about that? Yeah.
Yeah. good guys, man.
How does that make you feel?
It's a groovy situation.
You're having a groovy situation.
Coming up, man.
So this next song, hold on. What's this next song, we have not, or did not, ever sing this song on stage. It was just a thing. We recorded it and we migrated. So very interesting. Tell me what you think, huh?
All right. We, you know, as I mentioned earlier, we started singing at age 16, and we lived in the same neighborhood. You want to tell the story?
Yeah, well, I mean, he's asking me to talk. I don't know where he went. Anyways, yeah, we started out five people, and, you know, along the way, a few guys dropped out because of one reason or the other. And so we persevered, you know, and the first time we went together, like auditioned, you know, it was very discouraging because they told us we needed to rehearse some more. But anyways, we persevered and we've come along, you know, so we're here now.
We started out as a 5-man group, by the way, because we wanted to sing harmonies and, you know, and the Temptations and the Four Tops influences.
69. We're little kids then. Yeah.
But in the process of going around and getting auditions done, we wound up with Derek Harriott. Yeah. And one of the things that we thought was that because Derek was a singer, he would appreciate what we were bringing to the table, you know, harmonies and all. There was only two of us left, you know. But, and he did, actually. He did appreciate the fact that we wanted to sing harmonies and the songs that we were doing were harmonious, you know, so it worked out good. So in the process of singing for Derek, by the way, during that time, just so we know where we are in terms of, and we only represent Rocksteady. That's what we are about, okay? You come to hear dancehall, you're not talking about Geek of Tex.
It's not us, man.
Rocksteady. And during the same time, in our little group of singers were Dennis Brown, Junior Mervin, Police and Thieves, remember that? Bunny Brown, who else? Ethiopians.
Kingstonians. Rudy Mills.
Rudy Mills, all in that same stable for Derek Harriott. So we were surrounded by some really good singers, you know? So it kind of, and we rubbed off on each other because many of the songs you may hear Derek Harriott sing, we harmonize them. Bunny Brown sing, Keith and Tex harmonize them. Junior Mervin, all the guys who were there. So we were like an ensemble, if you will. You know, a group of people who were just working together.
A stable, man. Yeah. Musical chariot stable.
So the next song we're gonna do, we actually took to Derek Hyde and said, this is what we wanna record. And he looked at us and he said, why, me like the song, you know? Give me no man. So the next song Derek Harriott did, we harmonized him, goes like this.
Walk the streets at night.
Hold it back.
Looking for someone.
Thank you.
gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's take the opportunity to pick up the band.
Give yourself a round of applause again. I want to tell you something just really quick. We're honored to have them here just like you, and we're so blessed to be up here with them. So thank you for allowing us that opportunity, Sierra Nevada. I know how you feel about the music. We feel the same way, so we just try to share it. And they will be over here after they're done performing. They'll have their CDs for sale. You'll be able to take pictures, have things signed if you brought some records or you just want to meet with them and talk to them and share your love, take some pictures. They're more than happy to do that over at this table. We'll be over there to accommodate you and keep the positive vibes flowing today. Have a beautiful day. Thank you.
Next song. The next song, my... Bring it on, guys. My cousin married this guy. And she said, Keith, this guy can sing, you know. Won't you introduce him to Derek Harris? So we listened to him and he sounded pretty good. So we introduce him to Derek, and this is the song he sang. Thank you. Thanks, Eddie. Thanks. Thank you so much.
To lead you to a wonderland.
For you. It did pretty well in England. What happened? Went down to Jamaica, and across the street from where we live is Lee Scratch Perry. Anybody know him? You know him? Oh, wicked enough. So anyway, we went over and said, "Wagwan Scratch, how you the man? How the run-ins?" And he said, "Why, everything cool, you know, blah, 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 blah." So he said to you, said to us, "What? We don't have any music." We said, "Do we not sing, man? We not must have music. You gotta have music if you're a singer." So the next song came about by Perry, Lee Scratch Perry, sent a little 5-year-old kid. Said, "I want you to go find these people here, him, and him, and come back." In about 15 minutes, we had a wicked session in effect, and this is the result of it.
Right.
Stop at noon. It's
Songs, man. This guy was on top of the music. Let's do it again, guys.
Sierra Nevada, how are you feeling this morning? Was this a nice wake up, refreshing surprise and pleasure for all of us, right? Keith and Tex, big round of applause, please. Wish them well on all their journeys. Blessing the legends, keeping the music alive.
Do you want more from Keith and Tex? Then lift your glasses.
Monumentally missing out. It's their loss. I gotta tell you, give it up for Keaton Tex. Give it up for Keaton Tex. I remember in the words of St. Jude, not everyone has to follow the same path, but those who are following the path of Keaton Tex and Rocksteady, we welcome you. We thank you for coming out here. Of course, you could be sleeping and doing so many other things, but you've taken the time out of your schedule to come here.